Hey everybody, and welcome to another Cricut Craft tutorial. Before we get started, be sure to check out my Instagram listed down below. I post a lot of fun crafts that I don't necessarily do tutorials for, and some fun reels, lots of fun stuff over there to check out. Make sure to give me a follow, and I will follow back. In today's video, we are going to do some work with some of the products that came in the 143 Vinyl VIP Favorite Mystery Box. These are all things that me and the other VIPs picked out as our favorite items that we just absolutely love and want everyone else to be able to check out. So if you got a box, awesome, but if you didn't, don't worry. I'll link everything that we're using in the video down below for you guys. Today's video, we're also going to talk about font duos and how to work with them, because this shirt was done with a font duo and it's super easy. What I love about them is it really takes a lot of the guesswork out of, is this font going to look good with this other font? So this gender reveal shirt is what we're making, and we're going to use Caesar Sparkle and Starcraft Soft Flex. Now these press at two totally different temps, times, and pressures, so I'm going to show you guys how to do this without damaging any of your vinyl. Let's get started. I can't wait to show you how to work with these products. Whatever we would do, we do it just for fun. Working with a font duo is a great way to take out any of that guesswork whether the fonts are going to look good together. So I'm going to show you how to do this because it's really easy. And what I love is that with those font duos, you know that they're going to match. You know that they're going to look good together. So we're going to open a text box, and I'm actually going to type the word pink and blue into my text box. Text has been a little bit funky the last couple of days, so it's been very, very slow. So if you're having trouble with it like I am right now, it is helpful sometimes to restart your computer or your design space. But I'm gonna put these on two separate lines. It's gonna make it easier to separate them when I need to. So I'm going to go over into my text font selection, and I'm gonna go to my system fonts. And we are going to use a font called Hello Gorgeous. So I'm going to just search the word hello, and it should bring up the ones that we're going to use. My fonts are being really funny right now, so I'm going to try to show you this. It's being a little bit funky, so hopefully this works. So what we're going to do is go to the font pull down menu, and I'm going to go into my system fonts, and I want to search the word hello because we're going to use a font called Hello Bluebird. So I'm just going to search the word hello. And you'll see that we have Hello Bluebird Sans and Hello Bluebird Script. We're going to use Script for the pink and blue. That looks super cute. I love the little heart over the eye. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to click Advanced, and I'm going to ungroup this to lines. That way I can move the blue individually from the word pink. Before we do anything else, let's just go ahead and change these colors to pink and blue. So we're going to do that one in pink, and we'll do this one in blue. And now we need to put the rest of this together. So we need to do a few more little pieces of text. So we need the word or, which we don't want to capitalize. We're just going to do or. So it's going to say pink or blue. We already, and then there's going to be a heart and the word you. So again, because I need to separate these in a different way, I want to put them on separate lines. It's going to make it easier when I go to ungroup. We're gonna use the Hello Bluebird Sans for this part, so go ahead and select Sans, and it will change the font. It may take a second, it's a little bit slow. So what I'm gonna do again is click Advanced, and I'm gonna ungroup to lines again. This way I can individually move words, like the word or, which I want to be a little bit smaller, and I'm going to kind of move these around a little bit. So what I wanna do is I want to make sure that all the bottoms of these are kind of more like matching. So I need to move the blue down just a smidge, and I use my box to kind of see if it's even. That looks pretty good. We're still gonna end up moving these around a bit since we are gonna put them on the shirt, but we just get a visual this way. We need to reduce the size of the word we already and the word love you. Now you can see what it's doing. It's kind of being funny and bouncing around, so just mess with it. It may take a minute. And you, and we're gonna change these around a little bit as we play. But I'm gonna use an image from Cricut Design Space. I'm just gonna use this little heart that I found in here. It's like the perfect little sketch heart, and it's so cute. So again, Cricut Design Space is being a little bit slow, but when it is slow, just kind of, you gotta give it a minute. And I'm gonna scroll down because I know that that heart that I wanna use was down a little bit, but I kinda wanted like a sketched out looking heart. I didn't want like a solid one. I want this one right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and insert the image. Now I'm cutting all of this stuff in white, but right now I'm just gonna use these colors and I'm just gonna size everything. So I don't want the heart to be really big compared to the words. So I'm gonna go ahead and size that down. And then I wanna move the word you over so that that's all spaced correctly. That looks pretty good, pretty close to where I want it. And now I can expand this so that it's as long as the words pink or blue. I think that looks pretty good. It looks really even. So while we're here, let's just go ahead and weld this line. We're gonna weld it so that everything stays in place and it all looks nice and neat. And then I'm gonna take the word or and the we already love you. So both of those parts, I'm gonna select them and I'm gonna go ahead and attach. That way when I go to click make it, they stay in place. And let's just turn them white because that's the color that we're gonna cut them on. Now we can size our image to whatever size we want. So I'm putting this on a large shirt. So I'm gonna go about 9.5. Now, if you wanna know what this is gonna look like against a black shirt, go ahead and click blank canvas. And at the top, click color and change it to black. It's gonna change your canvas to the color of whatever you choose. So on this one, we are using pink or blue. We already love you. And I think we're good to go. But remember, we're cutting this on HTV. So what we wanna do is I'm gonna select the entire design. I'm gonna click flip and then flip it horizontally. That's basically mirroring it before you send it to the make it screen. I tend to forget to mirror if I click make it and then I totally forget. I get into the mode of like making sure I choose the correct settings and all of that. So I like to flip it here. When you click on make it, now I'm using the maker 3, so it's gonna ask me whether I want to use a matte or not. In this case, we are going to use a matte because we're using Caesar Sparkle and we are using StarCraft Softflex. So these are two products that right now cannot be cut without a matte, so we're going to go ahead and tell it to use a matte. Once it loads this, you'll see that everything should be flipped. I always just check just to be certain and I make sure that everything looks good, like it's set up correctly. Now, this is sort of a nitpicky thing that I do. Rather than wasting these pretty large pieces of HTV, I'm gonna turn this upside down so that instead of it wasting HTV at the top, I can cut around this and I'll have bigger pieces left over. That's just sort of a nitpicky thing that I do. It's really up to you. We're gonna cut these both on the everyday iron-on setting, and then we're gonna weed them and get everything ready to press. So let's head over to the machine. When working with HTV, you want to make sure that you're putting the carrier sheet side down, which a lot of people will say shiny side, and that's not true for all of the HTV lines anymore. So it's always a good idea to just take your pen and peel a corner back just to see which side is which, if it's a vinyl or HTV that you can't tell. So the StarCraft Softflex is what we're cutting first in white. So we're gonna go ahead and I'll pull the machine in and then let me show you these as well. These are the two that we're cutting. These are the Caesar Sparkle. So these are really easy to tell which side is up because this one is the sparkly side will be up where this duller side will be down. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull the machine in so that you guys can see. And all we're gonna do is take, and I'm just using standard grip mat, just load this into the machine and we'll let this cut out and then I'm gonna weed everything and show you guys how easy this is to apply. Shirt. This is just a George brand from Walmart. It's 95% cotton and 5% spandex. Nothing special. But we are going to add our HTV to this. Now for this shirt, I'm just going to kind of stick these on here right now. We are going to layer this with doing the sparkle first and then we'll add in our
soft flex. We're gonna do that because we don't wanna overpress our soft flex too much because it's only pressed at 285. So by kind of giving it a little bit of less press time, it can be pressed at 305, so it'll be fine. So I laid my pink and blue down, and I actually think I did a decent job. Usually I have to kind of guess. So being that this is a V-neck and I know where this V sits on me, I know that this needs to be pretty close to the V to actually be where it needs to be. So typically on a regular necked shirt, you want to do about 3 fingers down from the collar, and the collar would sit up here higher. If you have a scoop neck, which is more of the rounded neck, it's usually about 2 fingers, and then depending on how deep your V is, it's gonna depend on how far down from that V you're gonna put your design. So I just like to kind of guesstimate if it's straight, and then I like to hold it up and I see if it looks straight. I think that actually looks pretty darn straight. So what we're gonna do is I'm leaving everything where it is. I'm gonna peel off the soft flex, which is the white, and making sure to hold the blue and the pink right where I had them, because that spacing was perfect. We are gonna press these for just a fairly short press. We're gonna do about, I would say, like 7 to 8 seconds on these, and then we will finish by pressing on to the white. So again, we have the heat press set to 305 degrees. So I'll take you guys over there and show you guys how we're gonna press. Before we're ready to press, I do get a lot of questions about my heat press, so I'll just go over a couple things with you really quick. I do have a Teflon sheet. It's attached to my heat press with just these little magnets. You can get these, I'll link them down below. They work great. And then I also have a pressing pillow under my shirt. I got this off of Amazon for really inexpensive. I will link this below. And my heat press itself is a 15 by 15 clamshell style heat press by Starcraft in the color mint. This heat press I've had for about 2 years as of filming of this video, and it is in perfect condition. It works great. I've been really, really happy with it, and I highly, highly recommend it. Now, if you shop from 143 Vinyl, you can use my code to save 5%, which drops the price of this heat press pretty good. So what we're gonna do now that it's all heated up, I'm gonna make sure that I don't have any wrinkles in my shirt under where I'm pressing. So you just wanna kind of double check like where your vinyl is, and then just kind of everywhere that's on your pressing pillow that there aren't any wrinkles, because that's gonna help you get really good pressure. So again, we are going to press this, and it's a medium to firm, so I like to do like a more firm. But what I'm gonna do is just press this for maybe 6 to 7 seconds. So I'm kind of watching my countdown here until it gets to about 13, and then I'm gonna go ahead and peel this up. Now we can peel these, that's a hot or warm or peel. So we'll go ahead and take those off, and then we're gonna add in our StarCraft Soft Flex. So with this one, we're gonna go ahead and line this up where we're happy. Make sure it looks pretty straight and even. That looks pretty good. So then what we'll do now is we're just gonna go ahead and press this for about 15 seconds. The StarCraft SoftFlex can handle it, so don't worry. It'll be okay, but I wanna make sure that we get a good press on the sparkle as well. So I like to kind of give it like a happy medium, but don't worry. The SoftFlex really can handle the heat and it will be fine. Even though it technically only presses for 8 to 10 seconds, that little bit of extra heat isn't going to hurt it. I'm gonna go ahead and peel that off, and our shirt is all done. I'll let you guys get a better look at this over on the table. Here is our finished shirt. This is super easy to do, and like I said, using font duos makes this stuff real simple. I will link everything that we used down below, the font, the vinyl, everything. So this is really fun, and you can see how sparkly this sparkle really is. What I like about it compared to like a regular glitter vinyl is this is smooth. So there's not that rough texture that you get when you have a glitter HTV. So a lot of times that stuff's kind of uncomfortable, but this is really soft, and you can see that it's very like soft on the shirt, where sometimes glitter vinyl can feel a little bit stiff. This stuff does not feel stiff at all. It's very, very soft. Very easy to work with, and I really love the colors that it comes in. So again, this is pink lemonade and cornflower blue, and then we just used white StarCraft Soft Flex for this, and this was really, really fun. I love how this came out. This was a simple, easy shirt to do. You can do any kind of style that you want, but these little gender reveal shirts are really, really fun. If you guys have questions or anything else that you're wondering about crafting or a tutorial that you're looking for, let me know in those comments down below. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Again, links for everything that we used are in my bio down below. That way they're really easy for you to find. And don't forget to use code Corinne at 143vinyl.com because that's going to save you an extra 5% on your purchases. And the way I look at it, you save 5%, that means 5% more money that you can spend on more crafting supplies. I hope you guys had so much fun checking out the Caesar Sparkle and this really fun gender reveal t-shirt. Have a great day and happy crafting.